Hi everyone, and welcome to Jane Talks Buffy, where I'll be talking about and reviewing all the episodes of Buffy the Vampire Slayer in order. Today, I'm looking at Season 5, Episode 15, I Was Made to Love You. We begin the episode with Buffy complaining to Giles about Spike while beating the hell into Xander.
Oh, Buffy, Xander, I'm sorry, I guess I got carried away. Are you okay?
I'm alive. I can tell because of the pain.
Buffy worries that she scares guys away, so Xander pep talks her, which earns him a cuddle. A car pulls up, and a woman gets out, having hitchhiked, saying she's looking for true love. And into the credits we go. Joyce and her twirly pretty dress are nervous for her date with Brian, while Tara and Anya chat about finances before running into the hitchhiker lady, who asks if they know Warren. But they don't, and I had convinced myself my whole life that this lady was the same person who played the evil puppet master in NSYNC's Bye 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 video. But apparently, it's not. That night, there's a party at the Bronze, which Ben is also at, and Buffy awkwardly laughs at his joke and they have a little flirt, before the same woman comes in looking for Warren, who grabs his girlfriend and rushes away, and Tara feels sorry for her. Spike approaches Buffy, who is pissed he's still in town, and tells him to sod off, before Ben gives her his number. So Spike goes to flirt with the woman, April, but she's not interested, and throws him through the window.
Bloody hell! He threw me through a window! What's that about?
Buffy tries to talk to her, but she chucks her across the room, and they decide she must be a robot, but it could take some time to track down Warren, before Buffy goes to rescue Giles from babysitting Dawn.
Well, we listened to aggressively cheerful music, sung by people chosen for their ability to dance. Then we ate cookie dough and talked about boys.
Joyce comes home happy after her date.
Oh dear. What? I left my bra in his car. I'm joking.
And teases her, which is cute, while April goes door to door looking for Warren. Give it a rest, lady. People are trying to sleep. The next day, Willow thinks she's located Warren, and Xander fantasizes about what he would do with a sex bot, but he's met with confused looks.
Too many girls. I miss Oz.
Same dude. Tara feels sorry for Warren, not being able to find a real person to love him, and Buffy calls Ben, right as he transforms back from glory, to arrange a date. Nice dress! Hideous artwork. Warren hurriedly packs, which Katrina doesn't understand, and when Buffy shows up, Katrina bails, while Dawn shouts out Ted, the creepy bastard, and Xander opens the door to a flaming Spike. No one is pleased to see him, and Giles shoves him and gets all up in his business before tossing him out, while April is tricked by some douchey guys who send her on a wild goose chase. Warren explains to Buffy he made the perfect girlfriend, which quickly became boring, and instead he fell for Katrina, so he left April without saying anything, hoping her batteries would run out, and Buffy is worried she's dangerous. April finds Katrina and asks her usual question about Warren's whereabouts, and they get into an argument which turns violent. Ooh, that's some wonky shot compositing. And what's all this bullshit in the background? The unconscious Katrina walks herself over to the bench, and April asks Warren why he didn't come back, and he admits he doesn't love her, and points her at Buffy.
She growls? You made her so she growls?
So the two women get into a fight, which wakes Katrina up in time for her to see April for what she is. Nice flip, and she flees in disgust. April is just about to kill Buffy when her batteries start to die, so Buffy sits with her on the swings and comforts her as her systems fail.
It's getting dark. It's so early to be dark.
Buffy tells April that Warren is proud of her and will come back for her, and she's happy as she shuts down entirely. Why does this footage look so weird? Buffy decides she doesn't need a guy right now and calls Ben back to cancel their date, which Glory is put out by, and Warren tries to make amends with Katrina over the phone, when Spike shows up, putting in an order for a Buffy robot. Buffy gets home to find flowers for Joyce from her new beau, and oh god no.
Honey?
Okay, I'm going to ignore the ending for now and discuss and count it next episode, which makes more sense when we get there. And instead, let's talk about April. She's portrayed really well, if a little goofily with the growling, and the actress does a really good job with the role, with the right amount of peppy versus obsessed. We get introduced to Warren, who will become very important next season, and trust me, you will want to punch him in his stupid face by then. He's played with a misguided arrogance, and already he comes across a little unhinged, which lays the groundwork perfectly for his story to come. The creation of April raises some questions, like how the hell do people keep creating hyper-realistic, sophisticated robots? But according to Joss Whedon, it's all down to the Hellmouth. And it also raises a good point about how there is no perfect partner. They can be everything you want, but that would take the unpredictability out of things, remove the passion, and make things boring. And even though Buffy did her superiority thing while Warren was explaining this, I really appreciated that Buffy stayed with and comforted April as she essentially died, because at the end of the day, it's not her fault. She was just doing what she was programmed to do. Warren ditching her and continuing to run away, as well as pretending to love Buffy to get April to attack her, is very telling of his character, and he will continue to try and run and shift the blame to others throughout his entire character arc. Poor Spike is once again used as a punching bag and doesn't fare well in this episode, leading to the creation of the Buffy bot, which will be important in the future. But whoa, Giles! We see again the extreme protectiveness he has over Buffy. And in a room full of Buffy's friends, he's the one who takes on Spike. Damn, Giles, you scary! Dawn doesn't feature much in this one, but when she does, I like her. She's not overboard like she is in other episodes. I wish she was like that more often. Aside from a bit of Spike cringe, I really enjoyed this episode, and the lack of glory works for me. It's nice to be taking a bit of a break from her. We have no deaths that I'll count right now, leaving us with 24 humans, 1 transformation, 27 vampires, and 10 demons. So there you have it. That was I Was Made to Love You. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, or come say hi on social media. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit that like button, it really does mean a lot, or consider subscribing if you want to be sired by my channel. Alternatively, feel free to check out my other YouTube channels. Thank you so much for watching, I'll speak to you soon,
and don't let the vampires bite.